Good morning. We are almost at the end of the topic, water chemistry. This is the last topic. Okay, in this session we are going to discuss about the definitions of COD and BOD, and we will be discussing about the determination of COD. Okay, so let us see what is this COD and BOD. You know friends, COD and BOD are important parameters. Okay, they should be found in water samples, you know, like lakes and all. It's one of the important parameter for the life of the aquatic animals. Why? You know, because you should have seen the drain. No, for example, drain, in the case of open drain it will be imparting a less smell, but in the case of a closed drains, once when it is open, no, any time it will be imparting a large amount of bad smell. Okay, that is due to, you know, like the impurities which is present in water, they want oxygen for oxidation of the impurities. Once the oxygen is stopped, no, that is in the case of closed drains, what happens, it will be using the dissolved oxygen which is present in water. Okay, water can dissolve some amount of oxygen in it, even it will be using that oxygen that time, no, further the impurities cannot be getting oxidized, so it will be imparting bad smell in water. Okay, so the presence of this water in this oxygen in water is very important. Okay, so one need to know the BOD and COD for the sake of the, you know, living things in the water. Okay, so let us see what is the COD and BOD. COD is a chemical oxygen demand. It is the amount of oxygen required for the complete chemical oxidation of organic and inorganic impurities which are present in a water sample by using a strong chemical oxidizing agent like a acidified potassium dichromate. Okay, so COD is a oxidation of the both the organic and inorganic impurities by using a strong chemical oxidizing agent like a potassium dichromate. What is BOD? BOD is a amount of oxygen required by microorganisms to oxidize organic impurities only. Okay, in the COD it is both organic and inorganic impurities, but here it is only organic impurities by microorganisms. Amount of oxygen required by microorganisms to oxidize the organic impurities present in 1 liter of wastewater sample that is kept at a temperature of 20 degrees for a period of 5 days. Okay, so BOD analysis, which cannot be done immediately, it will take time. Okay, 5 days has to be waited. Okay, because now it is oxidation by microbes, it will take time. So we have to keep at a incubation temperature of 20 degrees for a period of 5 days. But COD is not like that. We are carrying out by using chemicals. So it can be done when and where required. Okay. So the question asked here will be, define COD and BOD, which is highest and fastest. Okay. Like that they will ask. This question will be asked for 4 marks. So definitions, you know, COD is oxidation of both organic and inorganic impurities by using a strong chemical oxidizing agent. BOD is oxygen required by microorganisms, okay, to oxidize only the organic impurities present in water for 5 days kept at a temperature of 20 degrees centigrade. Okay, so COD is the highest parameter because it is the oxidation of both organic and inorganic impurities, and BOD is less as it is oxidation of only the organic impurities. And which is the fastest parameter means COD. Okay, COD can be done immediately, but for BOD it requires 5 days, no? So COD is fastest parameter and COD is the highest parameter. Okay, so we will move on to the next slide. Determination of COD. How to determine COD in laboratories? Okay, like here, how to determine COD means the principle in this method is like oxidation of organic matter and inorganic matter by using a chemical oxidizing agent like acidified potassium dichromate in presence of a catalyst such as a silver sulfate and a mercuric sulfate are used here. You know, here the method consists of adding excess of a potassium dichromate, okay, acidified with sulfuric acid to a known volume of the sample and back titrating the excess potassium dichromate, okay, against a standard FA solution. COD values are also expressed in a milligrams of oxygen per dm cube. Okay, here now what is to be done is here the principle is we are adding excess of a potassium dichromate, acidified potassium dichromate. Okay, in the back titration we are taking here 25 ml of the wastewater sample and we are also adding 25 ml of the acidified potassium dichromate. We don't know how much volume of the potassium dichromate is required, but we are adding 25 ml of the potassium dichromate, and we are also adding 1 test tube of the H2SO4 which contain the catalyst like silver sulfate and mercuric sulfate. The function of silver and mercuric sulfate here are, silver sulfate will be acting as a catalyst in oxidizing some of the organic compounds and pyridine. Okay, here no, the it is difficult to oxidize some of the organic compounds and pyridine. Okay, so if we use silver sulfate, they will be oxidizing these groups, and mercuric sulfate is added to bind the halides present in water. In water samples, in all the water samples, frequently chlorides will be present. If it is present, no, they will be interfering in the titration. They should not supposed to interfere. So to bind the halides present in water, we are adding a mercuric sulfate. When you add mercuric sulfate, the chloride is present in water will be binded as a mercuric chloride. Clear, no? Okay, so we are adding excess of potassium dichromate, okay, and back titrating here. Okay, I will tell you what is the back titration in the later stages. Procedure. See, we have to take the further to the measured volume of the wastewater sample taken in the flask. You know, usually we will be pipetting out 25 ml, and we have to add 25 ml of the potassium dichromate followed by 30 ml of 6 normal H2SO4, and we should also add silver sulfate followed by mercuric sulfate, and we have to reflux condense it for 2 hours. Okay, we have to heat the solution for 2 hours in a reflux condenser. After that, we have to cool the solution and titrate against excess K2CR2O7 against ferrous ammonium sulfate solution using a ferroin as an indicator. Okay, when you add ferroin, you will be getting the initial color bluish green color. You have to titrate against FeO solution until you get a reddish brown color. Okay, so I will tell you the procedure once again. No confusions here. You have to pipette out the wastewater sample and then add 25 ml of the potassium dichromate and 2 test tubes of H2SO4 to provide the acidic medium, and silver sulfate and mercuric sulfate. I told already the functions of silver is a catalyst and mercury to bind the halide ions. Okay, and we have to add few drops of ferroin indicator. You will be watching the blue green color, and you have to titrate against standard FeH taken in the burette until you get the color change of reddish brown. Okay, let the volume of the titrant consumed, that is, let the volume of the standard FeH consumed be AML. Okay, now we have to perform a blank titration. I told you, we don't know how much exactly potassium dichromate required, but we have added 25 ml. Okay, we have to find out how much exactly potassium dichromate required, right? So we have to do a blank titration. How to do the blank titration? Blank titration is similar to the back titration. Back titration means what we are discussing. Okay, normal titration is called as back titration here. It is similar in all the ways to the back titration, except the sample will not be there. Which is the sample here? Wastewater. Wastewater we should not take. Remaining all you have to take. That is 25 ml of the dichromate and 2 test tubes of sulfuric acid, silver sulfate, mercuric sulfate. Everything has to be taken. Indicator, everything. Only wastewater we should not take. Okay, perform a titration. That is called as a blank titration. What is blank titration means? Blank titration is similar to the back titration in all the ways. In all the ways, it is similar to the back titration. Only the thing is, the sample will not be there. What is the sample here? Wastewater. Except wastewater, everything we have to take and do one trial. Let the volume of the FeH consumed be BML. Okay. So the FeH consumed for a normal back titration is AML, and the FeH consumed for a blank titration is BML. Okay. And now you have to do the calculations to find out the COD present in the wastewater sample. That is by using a formula N. Okay. N, that is the normal idea of a ferrous ammonium sulfate. N into B minus A into 8. Okay. That is, volume is equal to N into B minus A into 8000 by 25 ml of the wastewater taken. And you are expressing it by milligrams per dm cube. Milligrams of oxygen per dm cube. Okay, N is the normality of FeH and B is the blank titrator value, A is the back titrator value, and 25 is the volume of the wastewater taken. You can find out the COD of the given wastewater sample. Fine. And friends, on this COD, numerical problems will be asked, direct sums will be asked. See, make use of the following data in a COD analysis. An effluent sample consumed 35 ml and 95 ml, okay, 19.5 ml. This is a blank and back titrator values is given, and normality of FeH is given, which is 0.05 normal. Okay, and we have taken the wastewater of 25 ml. So calculate the COD, okay, and define COD and BOD. Like this, the questions will be asked in your exam. You know the definitions for COD and BOD, that should be written. Then how to do the problem here? Use the formula COD is equal to 8000 into Y minus X. You can use B minus A or Y minus X. Okay. and then into z is the normality of FEA is the, you know everything, y you know, x you know, z also you know, and volume of wastewater sample also you know, all the values is known, just substitute in the formula, okay, and you will be getting the final value, fine. One more sum from the question paper. Direct sum will be given to you. See why blank titer value will be given to you. Back titration value will be given to you. Normality of FAS will be given. Volume of the wastewater sample is given. When you substitute all this in the formula, you will be getting the amount of the, you know, the milligrams of oxygen required for oxidizing the impurities, both organic and inorganic impurities, that is COD. Okay, like the sums will be asked on a COD. Fine. So this is the end of this chapter, dear friends. Okay, we will be meeting with the new topic shortly. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.